I will build a great, great wall.
Go back to your fucking country where they're bombing every day.
Every one of you are terrorists, I don't care what you say.
In a world beset with prejudice, can we all learn something about tolerance from the most unlikely of places? In Ramadan 2015, six strangers meet for the first time in complete darkness.
I think I spend more than 2.3 million on books. I read cognitive psychology, behavioral science. I've spoken at TED Talks.
أنا وايد أحب الطبخ. دائما يعني معظم وقتي أطبخ في المطبخ. طبعا يعني في المطبخ.
I first skydived in 2000 and really been hitting it hard since 2005. Pretty high risk activity for sure.
Oh my god.
That's how you know.
I didn't expect that.
When I saw Garrett on a wheelchair, I was completely taken aback.
Skydiver زلمي وعلى قاعد على الكرسي المتحرك.
As they discovered they shouldn't be quick to brand each other, they also discovered the world's most iconic brand, unbranded too. These cans were distributed for Ramadan to help spread the message.
الشخص مو بلازم يعني ننتقده بشكله لكن اول شيء نتعرف عليه عقب نقدر نقول كيف الشخص.
This gesture from the Middle East, a region not always known for harmony, has not only captured the imagination of locals, it has also reverberated around the world in a time when prejudices and stereotypes are at an all-time high.
The idea has influenced millions of mindsets from over 100 countries around the world, across 200 nationalities, to spread the message against prejudice.
It changes your mind, your perspective, your heart.
Reminding us that the things that bind us are always stronger than the things that divide us.
যে কামাই পয়সা আমার ফ্যামিলি খুব সুন্দরভাবে চলতেছে
हथौड़ा
पाना
ड्रिल
My husband just ruined a beautiful evening together by spilling his drink all over my dress. My husband just ruined a beautiful evening together by spilling his drink all over my dress. My husband ruined a beautiful evening spilling his drink all over my dress. My drink beautiful evening spilling dress. My beautiful evening dress.
Get the stains you hate off the clothes you love. Persil Power Gel.
My day was just awesome until this car drove past me on the street, splattering black mud on my jacket.
My day was awesome. It's helped us charge across the street, splattering black muck on my jacket. My day awesome.
It's helped
our street, splattering black muck on my jacket. My day awesome.
Hard wall.
Black muck jacket. My awesome black jacket.
Get the stains you hate off the clothes you love. Persil Power Gel.
My cute little puppy barks so loud that I drop my cup of spicy pumpkin latte on my pajamas. My cute little puppy barks so loud that I drop my cup of spicy pumpkin latte on my pajamas. My cute little puppy so loud drop my spicy pumpkin latte pajamas. My cute little pumpkin latte pajamas. My cute pumpkin pajamas.
Get the stains you hate off the clothes you love. Persil Power Gel.
The business center of Delhi is also a hub for traffic jams, and India's most holy animal is also one of the biggest causes of this congestion. Cows are sacred in India, and it is customary to allow them to roam free. When they move, you move. When they stop, you stop. How do you turn a leading cause of traffic into a way to avoid it? The Traffic Guy. An initiative to help beat traffic jams on Delhi streets. With the help of local cow owners, we attached special transmitter collars around the necks of hundreds of cows, turning these roadblocks into traffic guides. We recycled old smartphones to create special solar-powered collars for cows. Through a custom-built application, we used the GPS function of the phones to track the exact location of each cow. The Traffic Guy app allowed users to see the location of the cows and traffic around them so that they could avoid them or use our smart routes. Cows have a unique way of navigating the city by using gullies and lanes. We used this unique tracking data to create new routes for every type of commuter. During peak traffic hours, the app even sent out automated live tweets to users with traffic updates. The reason behind some of Delhi's worst traffic became its most blessed solution.
Cut them cuts.
Pril dishwashing liquid has concentrated power. That means to completely clean a whole set of dishes, it only takes one drop of Pril. That's what we've been saying for years. Until our competitors started promising the same, we needed to make a stand by turning our everlasting promise into something our customers could actually grasp. Meet the Pril One Drop Bottle. The exact Pril detergent bottle reduced to the size of a thumbnail. Carefully crafted in a 6-month production process. The special edition bottle went big on supermarkets across the region. To amplify the message, we created a series of short films, GIFs, and posts for social media. The drop was so powerful, it made quite a splash. Pril, making dishwashing easier and much more efficient, one drop at a time.
Before you can finish your 3D pie charts for tomorrow's presentation, and your boss, colleagues, and the potential client loves it and loves you, and they ask you to join them for 3 times the pay, and you say yes, and the violins play, and your chauffeur-driven car waits outside, and you ask him to call you by your name instead of sir. And then they make you chairman, and triumphant you resign, because you've made more money than you could ever spend, and you want to find the true meaning of life. So you go out and buy your own football team and win the World Cup time after time, and then release an album and collect a record number of Grammys.
And before you save the pandas and find a cure for baldness, and you're offered the US presidency,
and they make a movie about you, your baby has to sleep tonight.
Johnson's Bedtime Baby Lotion, for babies and their parents.
In 2015, Dubai Cares launched a campaign that not only changes the way we help educate kids living in poverty, it changes the way we think about charity. In a first-of-its-kind skill exchange between children from the developed and the underdeveloped world. With donor fatigue threatening donations and the tendency of social media charity campaigns to generate more likes, pins, shares than donations, we decided to look for kids who have never been to school, but never stopped learning, and ask them to give a little bit back, to teach us a thing or two. With online tutorials.
Cardboard. Toilet.
All they ask in return.
Can you teach me to read?
And that's exactly what people did. Children drew up the alphabet, and adults shared text and pictures on Instagram to make an ABC book from the heart. Dubai Cares is sending thousands of copies to the children who need them the most. The campaign doubled last year's contributions, raising millions of dirhams to provide education to children who may need our help, but are anything but helpless.
I don't know, it's just always trying to be ahead of the curve in a big way. I guess our best way to be fresh. We hire differently than most people. We make sure we have a mix of cultures, mix of nationalities, mix of people. We always look at different brands that we have, and we speak to our brands a lot, and all the clients are on board with our approach and our strategy, and they all want to do fresh work. Our whole attitude is all about doing what's next, not what's current. In the past, lots of people look at what won last year and try and do it again. We never do that. We look at what won this year or last year and we don't do that. We do the next thing. And that's our way of staying fresh, I guess. I think that's the best way to put it, is just do what everyone else is not doing.
A lion is the best you can ever have. So, I mean, as far as winning a lion is concerned, is it really important for an agency or for a team of creative people? Of course it is. I mean, there's nothing better than that. So, winning a lion is like winning the ultimate. In terms of what it does to us, I mean, for the agency, obviously, it brings clients on a great pedestal. It brings the agency on a nice platform where the agency then can say, listen, it's kind of great work that we do. And for people as well, right? People who constantly, you know, late shifts in advertising and how difficult and how much input people give. So when you win something for the hard work that you've done, it obviously sort of really helps. And then winning a lion then brings a lot of great talent into the agency as well. So yeah, it's very, very cool and very important.
Radio, it's not. I don't think it's only in the UAE. If you think about radio, anywhere globally, it's one of the toughest media to crack, really, because you have to have a really good idea, a good storytelling, to pull the consumer or to pull the listener to your idea, and grab their attention, and then you have to do that in a medium that you just have to hear. So it's been a challenge. Even if you look at radio, across the region, our region, you don't see many winners because it's not an easy one to win. If you crack it, then you win big, and you win in many award shows, which is something really interesting. So it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of hard work to get that idea, write it well, and execute it well as well to make it work.
I don't think really there's an exclusivity about what kind of creativity people are looking for. Whether it's humorous, whether it's, I wouldn't call it sentimental, but perhaps emotional, doesn't really matter. Although it is quite interesting because I do think there is a move away from banal humor to more human touching stories, ideas, concepts. But at the end of the day, I just think if you do anything well, whether it's humorous or emotional or somewhere between the two, if you do it well, it's valid, and I think it will be recognized.
And I feel that it just has to look fresh, like whatever we do, it has to just be new, like we have to keep trying and pushing the boundaries.
We don't consider technology to be a media. It's just a reality that what's happening is just like a couple of decades ago, radio, everyone was talking about digital as a new emerging media, but it's it's not a media, it's actually a reality that was happening. And I think that a lot of the technology that has been applied to benefit of communication has given us a little bit more space and freedom and a little bit more more open windows actually to create more stuff that could be memorable and creative. And I feel that we could see in this Cannes Lion that there was a lot of emergence of VR and different things that we could do actually in terms of technology. And I think that mostly what happens is that all the agencies see this and they come here and they try to repeat the same thing that was done in Cannes. And but the thing is that you never know what's going to come next, no? And next year there's a lot of things that could surprise us way beyond VR in a sense. So of course we embrace it as much as we can, as much as our budgets can allow us and timings can allow us to experiment and create new things. So.
Cannes Lions is by far the most important award in the world for advertising, especially creative. And to go there, I think, because the work nowadays, you see it all the time. So you go to the website and you can see the work. And honestly, most of the work that wins there, we know it before going to the festival. But by going there and seeing what is winning, and by talking to people and exchanging real time with other creatives, with different impressions that they have about that work, that is priceless. That gives you the opportunity for you to really exchange in a higher level, in a place where you can combine the best creatives in the world in the same place. So, in my opinion, that's the best and the most interesting part about attending to the festival.
Actually a very interesting experience because it was the first for me to go there to Cannes. So as a young creative, to see something like that, I think it was very, very fulfilling and exciting.
Yeah, inspiring 24/7 and getting the chance to get to know all these people, all those people with from all over the world. We competed with the best and against the best. So.
And we found out that cyber this year was record-breaking, 50 teams to 100 people in total. So that was like, wow, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
Well, I attended and I realized that there's so many students from all around the world, and the most surprising thing for me was that we all had the same, a similar approach in teaching and approaching a problem. So that was like a pleasant surprise. Like I felt like I was on the same almost global stage as everybody else. So even going to Cannes, it felt like you were joining this whole community and another, like a broader spectrum of creatives. Like you're going there to celebrate and critique and admire all the work that's being put out there. So another thing is, I felt like the art was elevated to a more sophisticated level. So it really gave me purpose and reminded me of why I wanted to, why I even chose this major in the first place.